Okay, our next speaker really does not need an introduction. Joe recognized her husband, Steve White. She's a longtime activist and community advocate in Spring Valley. And she's been fighting for the school children in East Ramapo for years and many other causes. And I should mention that she is currently a member of a three-trustee cabal, I'll say, that has taken control of the Spring Valley Board away from a irresponsible and dysfunctional mayor so that they can try to right the ship in Spring Valley. And some of you may have seen some of the video of the abuse and the grief that she has to put up with, and yet she braves it with dignity, and we thank her for that. With no further ado, let me introduce Emilia White.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's a hot day, but we're here for a good cause. It makes me feel really, really, really happy to see all these elected officials here, especially, well, I know Executive Ed Day would be here, but I'm extremely happy to see Assemblyman Zabrowski here, because I know he's going to have people talking to him, asking him why did he support this. I live in Spring Valley, and I'm a trustee in Spring Valley, but I'm here as a human being because, you know, I live in Rockland County, and that's something that's going to affect everyone, even if it doesn't affect you personally, but it's going to affect you in some ways. I was speaking to this lady the other day, and I asked her, I said, what do you think about the chicken slaughterhouse? And she said, well, I don't know, it's up there, it's not down in Spring Valley. I said, yeah, that's what people said for East Ramapo when we were fighting and asking for help and saying that the children weren't getting an education. It's in East Ramapo. Now it's in Lakewood, it's up in New Jersey, it's going places. And it's an ugly thing, you know, when you think that you take your children, you have your children, you send your children to school, and you have to worry about them getting an education. That's the same thing with the chicken slaughterhouse. It's like parking your car in the middle of the highway. It doesn't belong. We're not saying we don't want it here because it's not supposed to be here. We don't want a chicken slaughterhouse. It's perfect upstate where there aren't any homes around here. Around it. I'm sure everyone here, when they chose their home, they look at the trees, the grass, the neighborhood. They didn't look for a factory. So we don't want a factory in between our homes. It's unhealthy, it's unethical, it's not neighborly. Whatever happens to love thy neighbor. So we have to keep that in mind when we think about that. For those who think that this is not going to affect the community, it will affect the community, and we know it. So reality, when you look at it, it's good to be truthful, to be true to yourselves and say, this is going to affect everyone, and we have to do something about it. So many speakers said it, you know, I don't know, Assemblyman Zabrowski, Ed, every speaker said exactly the same thing, really. When you summarize it, it doesn't belong in that spot. It should be someplace else because it would affect the community. So I applaud all of you, the neighbors, and thank you all for fighting. Keep up the fight. I'm here 100%.